Fellow Toastmasters, newcomers, and guests. Despite all the obstacles, the spring is finally coming. Denise, do you feel the spring in the air?
Yes.
Great. Spring, it's the season of high spirits, the time to express your feelings, your love. Isn't it, Nick?
Surely.
Wonderful. So, let's talk about poetry. Because who knows, maybe once in a blue moon, you could possibly want to recite something inspiring to your beloved. And as a Toastmaster, you should do it with passion, emotionally, with all your heart. That's what's called interpreting poetry. And it's quite an important thing. Why? I'll explain later. April, for example, in the USA, is a month of poetry. By the way, do you love a foreign poetry? No, it's not your cup of tea. And you are right. Indeed, in all languages, understanding poetry is really a challenge, a hard nut to crack. Nevertheless, please, don't be too scared of it. The devil is not so terrible as he is painted. The first thing you have to do is to make yourself understand every single word of the poem. Then, read the poem aloud many times, trying to seize the rhyme, beats, and intonation of the poem. And finally, when you begin feeling the music of the poem, oh, you'll get a great pleasure, believe me. Tonight, I'd like to recite a poem by a famous American poet, satirical poet, and one of the most essential and influential women of her time, Dorothy Parker. Two characters in her poem, he and she. She completely fell in love with him. She loves him deeply and ready to do everything for him. But he treats her only as an old friend, as a good buddy, nothing more. Telling her about his win, his romances, about his numerous adventures. Not noticing, or pretends not noticing, her feelings at all. A Certain Lady by Dorothy Parker. And smile for you, and tilt my head, and drink your Russian words with eager lips, and paint for you my mouth's fragrant red, and trace your brows with tutored fingertips. When you rehearse your list of loves to me, oh, I can laugh and marvel rapturous eyed. And you laugh back. Oh, can you ever see the thousand little deaths my heart has died? And you believe so well I know all my part, that I am gay as morning, light as snow. And all the strange things within my heart you'll never know. Oh, I can laugh and listen when we meet, and you bring tales of fresh adventurings, of ladies delicately indiscreet, of linking hands, and gently whispered things. And you are pleased with me, and strive in you to sing me sagas of your late delights. Thus do you like me, marveling, gay, and true. Nor do you see my staring eyes. Cake. But learning poems by heart can help you not only develop your English, but most likely to improve your memory as well. So pick up the poems you really enjoy. Learn them by heart and enjoy yourselves. With some efforts, I am sure you'll certainly succeed. And as always, good luck!